Hello everyone, welcome to OJAS with IAS Academy. It is India's best online platform for UPSC guidance. I am Khushbu Sisodia and I am going to discuss 10 MCQs on daily current affairs. So let's begin with question number 1. Question number 1 says, Competition Commission of India plans to assess the country's media. Consider the following statements in this regard. So they are asking about that CCI is planning to assess country's media. Consider the statements regarding this. It means they have given 4 statements and you have to find out which of the above statement are correct. So let's read the statements given below one by one and then we will find out the correct answer. So the first statement is Competition Commission of India is a body of government of India responsible to prevent activities that have an adverse effect on competition of India. So this is correct. And let me tell you guys, this competition, we must have heard about this word competition in our life so many times. So let me tell you the importance of this word. This is very, very important for any kind of market, because not just from the point of view of a customer, but from the point of view of seller as well. It has different perspectives from both the sides. So this is true. Let's move to statement number 2. CCI is quasi-judicial statutory body established under the Competition Act 2002. This is again true. It was established in when? 2002. So statement number 1 and 2 are correct. Let's see if we can eliminate any of the option. A is eliminated. B is also eliminated because they have given 1, 3 and 4. But our statement 1 and 2 both are correct. This is also eliminated. C can be our answer. So we have to read all the statements first. So the commission is also required to give opinion on competition issues. They are saying they are supposed to give views on their opinion on competition issues. On a reference received from a statutory authority established under any law. So yes, it is mandatory. It is they are required to give their opinion. So this is also correct here. C can be our answer, but still we have to read 4. Fourth statement. The Competition Act 2002 prohibits anti-competitive agreements, abuse of dominant position by enterprises and regulates combinations. This is again true. So the thing is, all 4 statements are correct. So C is not the answer and D is our answer. It means all 4 statements are correct. Because they are right, it is a government body, it is a quasi-judicial body and a quasi-judicial statutory body, plus it involves a lot of many number of experts in it, and they give us views on so many important topics. So this is a very important aspect of Government of India. Question number 2. Question number 2 is, consider the facts about animal human organs transplantation. So in this question, they are going to ask about the transplantation. So this question is from Science and Tech. So there are 3 statements given, and which of the above statement is or not correct. So we have to find out the incorrect statement. Whenever they ask you about the not statement, correct, incorrect statement, you have to mark it so that you don't forget that you have to find out the incorrect statement. So first attempt at animal to human transplants was made very recently. This is not correct, my friends, because it is not very recent. It was done in 1838, which is not at all nearby date. So it was a very long time back. So long time ago they did this, and the corona of a pig was transplanted successfully in human eye. So let's move to our second statement. Xenotransplantation is transplanting of organs from one species to another. So yes, this is correct. But the thing is that our doctors in government is being so cautious about this that this topic is always under a lot of discussion. So yes, this is true. So statement number 1 in 2, we've got the answer. 1 is incorrect, but 2 is correct. So let's read the third one. A pig's genetic makeup and internal organ particularly are non-similar to a human's. This is not correct. As I told you in the first statement, that the corona of a pig was transplanted in a human body and it was successfully done in 1838. Similarly, we are also planning to transplant few organs of pig into human beings because it is showing an indication of success too. So let's move to our question. Whether the answer is C. Because statement 1 and 3 are incorrect. So answer is C. Yes. Question number 3. Non-communicable diseases are posing serious challenges nowadays. Consider the following statement. So this is about the non-communicable disease. And we have to find out the correct options in this. So let's find the correct options. Let's read the options given one by one. Statement number 1 says, a non-communicable disease, NCD, is a disease that is not transmissible directly from one person to another. It is correct. Parkinson's disease is a non-communicable disease. So yes, friends, it is also a non-communicable disease because it is a nerve cell damage in the brain that is caused by a few things. So this is also a non-communicable disease. Therefore, statement number 2 is also correct. So both statements are correct. Both the statements are correct. Our answer is C. Let's check the answer. Yes. Here some diseases are mentioned which are non-communicable disease. You can go through the slide. Let me read few of them, like cancer, diabetes, chronic kidney disease, arthritis. There are few diseases that are not communicable in nature. So you can read the whole slide, pause the video and read the explanation. Question number 4. In the context of Indian economy, what do you understand by the term leverage ratio? You must have heard about this statement, about this word so many times. But what is leverage ratio? Pause the video and try and answer it first, then go ahead. Okay? So, I hope you guys have paused the video. Now, let's read the statements given one by one. Then, we will discuss the correct answer. Statement number 1. Leverage ratios are used to determine the relative level of debt loan that a business has incurred. So, is this right, friends? Before telling you the correct answer, let me tell you the meaning of leverage. Leverage is to uplift something. You know, when we use lever to uplift something, to open lid by making some pressure under it, that is how we use this word leverage. Similarly, the statement is saying that leverage ratios are used to determine the relative level of debt loans that a business has incurred. That is true because it evaluates a company's debt levels. So this is true. So if the A statement is correct, it means this is our answer. All three statements given below are not correct. But still, I will suggest you to read because there are options where they have written both A and B and none of the above. So let's read the second statement. A high ratio indicates that a business may have incurred a lower level of debt that it can be reasonably expected to survive with ongoing cash flows. So the second statement is, a high ratio indicates that a business may have incurred a lower level of debt that it can be reasonably expected to service with ongoing cash flows. So these ratios compare the total debt obligation to either the asset or the equity of a company. So this is incorrect. It means answer is A. Let's check the answer. Yes, answer is A. Let's move to question number 5. Question number 5 is, St. Helena Island is located in which water body? Guys, again, this question is from cartography, and I keep on suggesting, please give importance to cartography map work. I am going to give this section 5-star, because this is how I am going to show you the importance of cartography these days. Though UPSC is uncertain and unpredictable, still if you are doing this, it will help you in solving so many other questions as well. Because sometimes it happens, if something is in news, for example, let's see yellow sea is in news. So they might ask something related to yellow sea. So sometimes it helps you to find out whether you have heard this or not, but you know that this place is located in yellow sea or nearby. So this is how you can guess the correct answers. So let's move to the question. We have read the question that they are asking, where is the St. Helena Island located? So here the answer is, let's read the options first. Sorry. A. Yellow Sea. B. Pacific Ocean. C. Indian Ocean. D. Atlantic Ocean. Friends, answer is G. Atlantic Ocean. Here is the map. This is St. Helena. So the answer is D. And this is St. Helena. Let's move to question number 6. So the question is, recently CBI seeks Lok Sabha speakers not to prosecute 3 MPs. Consider the following sentences about the prevention of corruption, Amendment Act 2018 in this regard. 4 statements are given, and they are asking about which of the following statement are correct. So here we have to find out the correct statement. Gifts received for established undue advantage or malafide motive are now considered as an act of corruption. This is true, friends, because earlier they used to use this ambiguous word gifts to take bribes, or this was uplifting the number of corruptions cases. So this is correct. Question number 2, statement number 2. For the first time, the giving of bribe has now been made a direct offense on par with taking of bribe. This is also true. You must have seen so many videos getting viral on Facebook and Instagram these days, or in social media, where they are making videos of those officials or MPs who are taking bribe and making them lie. This is how, because people are becoming aware these days, so they have to keep on updating such things. So this is also correct. Third statement is, superiors to be held if employee or agent has bribed with their approval. This is also correct. So 1, 2 and 3 are correct. So this is not our answer. Here they have not mentioned 2, so it is also not our answer. Either it is C or it is D. The bill has removed the provision for prior sanction to prosecute former officials. This is not at all true, because they really need prior sanction. So the answer is C. So let's check the answer. Answer is C. Let's move to question number 7. Question number 7 is, government to bring ordinance to enforce ban on e-cigarettes. Consider the facts about e-cigarettes. Yes, friends, nowadays if you go in flight, they also announce that e-cigarettes and cigarettes are not allowed in the flight. And this is how this e-cigarette is becoming famous these days. And government has taken a very strict step against e-cigarette usage. So wherever you see such cigarettes, you should have this thing in your mind that this is banned. So let's read which they have given three statements, and we have to find out which of the above statement is or not correct. So we have to find out the incorrect statement. So let's read them one by one. An electronic cigarette is a battery operated device that emits doses of vaporized nicotine or non-nicotine solution for the user to inhale. This is correct. It aims to provide a similar sensation to inhaling tobacco smoke without their smoke. This is also correct. They are sold as aids to reduce or quit smoking. So yes, because they commit and they say that this is going to help them quit smoking because they are inhaling nicotine directly. But these all three statements are correct. Therefore, our answer is D, none of the above, because all these statements are correct. So yes, we got the answer, and answer is D, none of the above. Question number 8. Consider the following statements about proposed National Maritime Heritage Museum in India. So friends, you must have heard about this National Maritime Heritage Museum in India. So this is going to be a very important topic, because such questions they ask. So they have given two statements here. We have to choose the correct option. So let's read them one by one. The project is being implemented by the Ministry of Shipping through its Sagarmala program. This is correct. It is a factual information. So the second statement is, France will cooperate in setting up of National Maritime Heritage Museum at Lothal in Gujarat. This is incorrect, because it is not France. It is not France, dear friends. It is Portuguese. So the only one statement is correct. Therefore, one only. Let's check the answer. Yes, it is only one. Let's move to question number 9. In the context of Indian policy equality, which of the following is not the basic feature of Indian Constitution? So Indian Constitution is very important, dear friends. Polity is very important. You have to read this thoroughly. You have to read word by word. Each and every statement has a lot of explanation in itself. So let's read it. Rigidity of the Constitution. A. They have asked about which of these following is not the basic feature. Friends, our constitution is a mix of both rigidity and flexibility. So this statement is incorrect. Unity and integrity of the nation. This is correct. Article 32 and 226. Yes, this is also correct. Principle of separation of powers. This is also correct. The answer is A, because this is incorrect. Let's check it. Yes, rigidity of the constitution. Question number 10 in the last question of today's video. Let's read the question number 10. Gulf of Bothnia is located between which two countries? So friends, they have given four options. Let's read them one by one. And again, it is a question from map work. Cartography, which is very important. You have to read and practice it a lot. So let's see the options. Norway and Finland. No, it is not the correct option. Sweden and Finland. This is a correct answer. Russia and Finland. No. Russia, Norway. No. So let me show you this. So this is Baltic Sea. And this is Sweden, this is Finland, and this is Gulf of Bothnia. So you can now practice map as much as you can. You have to practice. This is Gulf of Bothnia, this is Finland, this is Sweden, this is Norway, this is Baltic Sea, Latvia, Estonia, Russia. So you can practice map. And this was all about today's current affair, guys. You have to practice these questions again and again. Don't forget to review, do the revision. As I finish this video, you please play the video again, watch it again, try and answer the questions which I have already told you. So this will help you remembering the answers for longer duration. So this was all about today. Thank you so much.